The U.S. markets are back approaching all-time highs as investors patiently wait for the Fed's rate decision this upcoming week. Last week, the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ were both up just about 1%, while the Dow Jones was up over 1.5%. But the big story was the Russell 2000, which is up almost 5% for the week. And now the Russell 2000 is up 17% for the year, while the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ are up over 20% year to date. Foreign and emerging markets also had a good week as they were both up just about 2%. And now foreign markets up just under 15% for the year, while emerging markets are up just under 9% year to date. We're looking at a chart of the Russell 2000 today after such a strong week last week. And the Russell has been a lagger all year in terms of closing in on its all-time high, even though it's up 17% for the year. Now, the huge move last week actually put the Russell 2000 right at a major resistance level, which is the blue line on the chart, at about 1600. Now, the all-time high on the Russell 2000 is around 1750, which is still about 9.5% away from where the Russell 2000 currently is. Now, with that being said, the Dow Jones, the NASDAQ, and the S&P 500 are right around their all-time highs. So we're looking for a continuation upwards for the Russell 2000 over the coming weeks. And if this does happen, then we could see the Russell 2000 approaching its all-time highs. And if that happens, then the S&P 500, the Dow Jones, and the NASDAQ will probably be above or at least at their all-time highs.
Oil prices skyrocketed over the weekend by over 15% as there was an attack on Saturday on Saudi Arabia's oil fields. That attack wiped out 5.7 billion barrels worth of production on a daily basis. Now, the Saudis said they're going to start rebuilding immediately, but it's going to take months to get back to normal. And in response, the United States said that they're going to open up their oil reserves, trying to combat higher prices. Now, the investigation is currently ongoing, but the initial thoughts are is that Iran could be behind the attacks, but the United States is waiting for the UK to bring back their report and lay out all the evidence that they've found. Also in the news last week, the ECB, or European Central Banks, cut interest rates by 0.1%. It's the first time they really took an initiative to cut rates and also add in a financial stimulus plan over the past 3 years. They also are encouraging central banks from around the world to follow suit. This immediately puts pressure on the Federal Reserve on their upcoming rate decision this week.
The biggest news story this week will be on Wednesday, when the Federal Reserve announces if they'll be cutting interest rates or not.
Thanks for watching, and if you're on Facebook, please like and share our video, and if you're on YouTube, please like and subscribe to our channel.